The mechanisms you need to put in place to detect and respond to threats as an enterprise depend on how well you're able to look across hundreds of thousands of devices, connected cloud services, on-prem systems, and identity providers at scale, and correlate those signals happening across your organization to detect and pinpoint security events. And today we'll take a deeper look at how Microsoft Sentinel, our modern cloud SIEM, does just that. It's designed to handle data ingestion at scale from your connected systems to identify security threats, which when combined with threat intelligence and automation, along with Security Copilot, can provide vital additional insights to discover and stop persistent attacks hidden in your network. And keep watching to the end, because if you're looking to migrate from your current SIEM solution, we'll show you how we've made that simpler too. And joining me today to go deeper on Microsoft Sentinel and our modern cloud-based SIEM is Security CVP Rob Lefferts. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks, Jeremy. So happy to be back.
Thanks so much for joining us today. You know, it's been a while since we've actually taken a singular look at Microsoft Sentinel. So how should we think about this as part of our unified security operations solutions?
Well, the SIEM is such a critical part of the SOC toolset. It's like the central nervous system for all of the security data that comes in. In fact, let me show you what I mean. Here, I have Microsoft Sentinel open with a view of all the connectors attached to this environment. Everything from multi-cloud services, firewalls, device sensors, identity and authentication systems, SaaS apps, and more. In fact, one huge advantage of Sentinel is the breadth of data it allows you to bring in from multiple clouds, services, and platforms with hundreds of available connectors. Now, even though the data that comes in is often text-based and each unit of information might just be a few bytes in size, that all adds up and can quickly amount to terabytes of data. For example, if I drill into this connector alone, there are millions of events that have been recorded. Of course, in each data type and log that you see connected, there are often just a few properties available to thread all connected activities together, like IP and host MAC addresses, URLs, processes, and usernames, to name just a few. This information all needs to be mapped against intelligence and corresponding properties known about the latest threat actors and their tactics. And this is where Microsoft Sentinel shines. It detects threats by logging and finding the connections across all integrated systems, users, devices, services, and corresponding activities across your organization, and then helps you to investigate and visualize exactly what has happened. This is something that would be impossible to do manually at scale. You need a cloud-native SIEM with built-in AI to do this.
That's right, and because threat actors, their tactics and the things that they're doing are constantly changing, it's one of the reasons why I think everybody from an IT perspective, we're always prioritizing getting those security updates and patches down as soon as possible and really plugging those vulnerabilities and making sure that we log the related events.
Yeah, it's critical that you push those updates out when you're closing known new vulnerabilities. Where a threat actor might breach your defenses and then try to get what they can before they're detected, that's like a quick grab-and-go theft. That said, another common tactic, and something we're seeing much more, is well-funded state actors who will breach security systems and then hide in the network, waiting for the right time, that could be days or weeks, in what's called a persistent threat, as they hide under the radar and slowly explore the network.
Right, it's kind of like those movies we've all seen where you've got a government spy who might be sitting years embedded into a country and then waiting for that precise moment to attack.
That's right. And remember how I said that the SIEM makes sense of terabytes of lightly connected data? Well, these systems are designed to hold only so much information, often covering just a finite amount of time depending on the data type. So that persistent threat, our embedded spy, once they've breached our defenses, can often just wait until their initial entry and tracks have been deleted, which could be as little as a couple of weeks. Let me show you a long-term persistent attack. This is a multi-stage incident involving execution and lateral movement with ransomware on multiple endpoints. It's really not good. In our case, thankfully, we can see that this attack was automatically disrupted, meaning that the attack has been contained. And in Microsoft Sentinel, as I dig in, down here in the tags, we see a couple of threat actors, Sangria Tempest and Storm 1113. Now, I'll introduce each threat actor in the activity log when we get there. Both are bad news, but when they work together, it's even worse. Now, let's dig into the full details. The first thing I want to take a look at is the activity log. Here, we brought in more information directly from threat intelligence using lookups with host pair IP addresses. We can see that Sangria Tempest specializes in human-operated ransomware attacks, We can see their tactics, techniques, and procedures, or TTPs. And if I scroll down, I can see Storm 1113 specializes in distributing malicious packages and payloads.
So it sounds like Sangria Tempest, they might have built the backdoor and kind of the ransomware and the software itself. Then they worked with Storm 1113 to kind of get that package out and distribute it out to the people they wanted to attack.
That sounds about right. It's an effective collaboration and not in a good way. You'll remember our suspicious URL called photoshop-adobe.shop. I'm going to copy that into my clipboard. And just to show you the connection, let me head over to Intel Explorer and Threat Intelligence. I'll search for this URL, and we'll see it has a high severity, was used by Storm 1113, and it resolves to this IP address, 173.255.204.62, that we saw before. Now I'll copy that and go back into Intel Explorer and paste in the IP. And now I'll go to the Resolutions tab and search for any matches. And I don't see the Photoshop URL near the top of this list, but I do see another URL from our investigation, workable.uk.com. When I click into that and then go to the Summary tab, you might have expected Storm 1113 because we know that they are linked to this IP, but it's actually Sangria Tempest, our other threat actor. And they were using this IP address at the same time for around 10 days.
So anyone who's watching right now, they're using their own SIEM. How easy is it then to move from what they've got now to Microsoft Sentinel?
You know, we're getting this question a lot recently. And the good news is that we've made the migration simple to bring over your logs. Back in Sentinel from the Content Hub, you just go to the SIEM Migration Wizard. It explains the prerequisites for analytic rule dependencies, data availability, and access requirements. Next, we give you the query you'll need to run in order to migrate your content as JSON. I've got one of these ready to go, so I'll drag in my JSON file. From there, the schema is automatically mapped, and you can see the mapping success column, and optionally, you can make changes to the mapping. Here, for example, we see a registry path without a match. This isn't critical, so I'll save changes and continue to rule configuration. Here, too, we've translated the rules from your Splunk output to work with Sentinel. You can see how many are fully translated versus partially translated, and you can edit from here or do that later in Sentinel. For now, I'll just save changes. Then I'm ready to review and migrate, and I'll confirm. That takes a moment to run, but we'll speed it up to save time. And once it's complete, in Sentinel Analytics, you'll see all of the new rules that we brought over from Splunk, and we just need to check and enable the rules, and that's it.
So now there are really no trade-offs in terms of your SIEM and the data that's available to you in order to investigate attacks.
And as we showed, you can leverage automation for detecting and responding to ongoing attacks. There's easy access to insights from extensive threat intelligence at your fingertips. GenAI is integrated into your automation flow with Security Copilot, all efficiently saving you more time and keeping you ahead of threats. And there's a lot more to come, so watch this space.
I'm looking forward to seeing what's next for Microsoft Sentinel. So for anyone who's watching, what should they do to get started?
Easy. You can learn more and get started at aka.ms/Microsoft Sentinel.
So it's always fascinating having you on to really break down the latest threat tactics, along with the detection response updates that we're making. And we'll keep bringing you updates around our XDR solutions. So be sure to subscribe to see them in action. And as always, thanks for joining us today. And goodbye for now.